Hello people, welcome back to my channel. I'm called Elomo Carol and I film about relationships, growth, lifestyle, and this is
Martin Gulefa,
a regular guest on the channel. So today we're talking about dating with expectations. We know a lot of young couples out there actually have a lot of expectations in their heads, the kind of perfect relationship everybody has in their head. Like, everybody has already drawn the kind of idea of the relationship you want in their head. So when you get into the relationship, you're expecting your partner to act in a particular way to rhyme with what's in your head. Yeah.
So and sometimes when they don't give us what we expect from them, it goes bizarre. Or
is that feeling frustrated, yes, angry?
You feel so frustrated and it may end the relationship, or you start having issues inside or even with yourself,
having conversations with your head,
maybe he does not love me and all of that. So I just think that the first thing you have to do to avoid expectations is you have to love yourself. Love yourself totally and completely. You have to accept everyone the way they are. When you do that, you know that, okay, I don't expect this person because this is what he is or this is what they are. And we did a video about money in relationship, and this money to now comes here because there are sometimes that we expect gifts or we expect presents or that we
if
expect
you
money
that
totally.
Video, the link is going to be in the description box so you can understand where we're coming from.
Yes, so your boy didn't need to give you money, but you should not expect it, or it should just come as a gesture in a way that if you don't expect it, then it always comes in a way that it makes you smile. But if you're always expecting money from your boyfriend and he gives you something, let's say example, he gives you 10,000, you're like, I was not expecting this amount, or it's too small, or is this maybe my needs overtake this money, or all of that. So I just think that even if you are here, to be truthful, there will be always a little bit of expectation. The truth is that expectations will never go away.
Yes. We are just trying to reduce.
Even me, myself, I also have more expectations. But what we should try to do is that limit those expectations as much as possible, because expectations break up relationships. When you start expecting too much, then
not only with your partner, it breaks like relationships in general, like between your sisters, friends, parents. The world in general, expecting from another person can really hurt you because people are unpredictable, so unpredictable. They decide when they want to act, what they want to do, and they change every time. Change is the one constant thing in life. So people always change. So do not expect somebody to be in a particular manner for a long while. People change, things change, so it's going to hurt you. Just limit your level of expectations. Learn to rely on yourself, because when you learn to trust and rely on yourself, I don't think you're going to have so much expectations being placed on another person.
And you have to always try as much as possible. If you're in a relationship, always try as much as possible to express your affections or express yourself. Like sometimes, I always want my girlfriend to tell me that I love you, or I always want my girlfriend to tell me that, hey, you look nice, or I always want my girlfriend to just like notice some things and just be vocal about them, so that when I hear them, I feel, I don't know if you get that feeling when your boyfriend tells you, but I feel, I have like a peaceful feeling. I feel nice about myself. So just be vocal. Sometimes we expect our partners to tell us something or to just notice something about
us.
To try to limit those expectations, make sure you do them. Just try as much as possible to tell your partner that, hey baby, I like this about you, or I like what you did there, or I like. Sometimes we especially boys feel proud when their girlfriends tell them nice things about them, or just tell them about a single or small thing they achieved when they were together. Boys feel nice. And try as much as possible to defend your partner, especially in public. Defend and protect them always, especially in public.
Always expect that of their partner.
Just try to protect and
both
defend
boys
them
and
always.
Girls, yes, that expectation is there.
And
you always expect your friend, your partner to defend you.
You can always, to reduce expectations, the most important thing you have to do is say what you feel. We should not assume. Just try as much as possible to say what you feel. If you feel this way, or you feel hungry and you want your partner to bring you food, say it. And you just say that, hey babe, please, can you bring me food when you are coming back? when you expect your partner to notice
automatically
and know that you are hungry and comes back
and you come back, trust me, you come back with nothing, empty handed.
Yes, you feel frustrated. You feel not frustrated and you may so bust angry. Up. Yes, you may bust up and then you just start nagging and you just start nagging.
And if he does not even understand where the anger is coming from, he too on his own end can just start really getting irritated because he doesn't understand where the attitude is coming from because you did not express yourself, but you're expecting him to understand what is in your head.
When there's noticeability and then there's expression and those two come together, I think that is easier. Because sometimes not all everybody wants to express themselves about this or about that, but try as much as possible to express yourself. Sometimes not everybody will notice that you need this and they'll say it. Try as much as possible to also notice it. Put yourself in their shoes. I just think that no matter how irritated you think that the person may be or how naughty you think that what you want to express is, just try as much as possible to express yourself. Express yourself. Just be vocal. Say what you want. And sometimes bring your partner together and say how you want it, because you just sit and just assume that no, you should be able to do this.
Especially when you admire, like you have a power couple, you're actually admiring, or your friend's relationship, you're actually admiring, and you want your relationship to be like that. You start expecting your partner to act the same way the other couples are acting. Do you get it? So it tends now to bring so much pressure and tension in the relationship because this person, especially when the partner who is expecting the relationship to be like the power couple's own, hasn't told the partner that, babe, I really want us to behave and act like these people I'm admiring or so. If the person is silent about that, you start expecting him to behave exactly like an unknown human being who is unknown to him. It tends to just mix up the whole relationship and brings a lot of confusion, sadness, and everything. Take what you can take from your power couple relationship, like take the best what you can take from them, but don't expect your partner to be exactly like your power couple. It can't work. The two are never the same. I mean,
they are two different beings, two different, because just as much as possible to make your own relationship the way you want it. And if you want to do that, you have to put your partner down, express yourself, say, babe, I want us to do it like this. Can you try as much as possible to be this, or let's be this? And the two have to come together. Some things have to go, some things need to come in. And when all of that comes in, you now understand that this is the kind of person he is, or this is the kind of person she is. And you try to limit those expectations and say that, even if I want something, I just ask, babe, can we do this? If it's a no, he makes you understand why it's a no. Or if it's a yes, he or she makes you understand why it's a yes. And you just have to supposed to limit those expectations, because expectations kills.
It kills a lot in the relationship.
Yes. You may just feel frustrated inside. It kills, as then you assume. So when you expect and it does not come as you dreamed about, then you start thinking that it does not come out because of this or because of that. And so many things play in your head, and you just calculate your own math, and then you have your own answer immediately, or your ex becomes this, and then you blow up.
And even if you're expecting something from your partner, you should tell your partner that, okay, I'm expecting you to act this way. Because there are times when people want to actually act that way, but they don't even know how to go about it. Like, for example, you're expecting you're expecting the girl to be your support system, or the other way around, or to be submissive to you. The girl can actually have in her head she has to be submissive to you, but doesn't actually understand that concept, or doesn't actually know how to go about the submission aspect. She knows in her head she should be. So times where you expect her to be submissive and she doesn't do it, tell her that, okay, this is how it's supposed to go. In this kind of situation, you as a woman, you're supposed to be submissive, you're supposed to do this, you're supposed to do that, you're supposed to do that. She might take it well, she might not take it well, but at the end of the day, you should express yourself that way. You expect her to be the submissive wife. She knows she has to be submissive, but maybe she doesn't just know how to go about the submission. So express yourself. If you want the person is supposed to be your support system, and you know that, okay, if you're doing this thing, the person is supposed to be the first person to do this, about support you in something, and the person doesn't do it, it doesn't necessarily mean the person doesn't want to support you. The person can want to support you, but doesn't really find your own method of the support, like, rhyming with the own. Do you get? For example, you're having a business online, you're running an online business, and your partner, you think in your head that your partner is supposed to actually be posting your business the same way you're posting on your social media account, and you know, he might be supporting you in a different way which you don't know. He might be sending customers to you which you have no idea about, but he doesn't just post, like he posts the business once in a while, or maybe doesn't post it as often as you think he's supposed to post it to show he's supporting you, and you keep it in your head and start getting angry and start getting worked up. He doesn't support you, but talk to him, you might find out that he actually is supporting you, but the method in which he's supporting you is not just the method in which you are expecting him to support you. So you guys will be clashing over unnecessary things. Meanwhile, he's actually doing what you're expecting him to do, but he's not just doing it in the manner in which you are expecting him to do. So communication at the end is key. It's very, very important to limit the level of expectations. Communication is super, super important. You cannot put anybody pressure to be the Cinderella or the Ronaldos you have in your head. It doesn't work that way. So learn to work with what you have and don't expect more than what the person can give you. With that saying, I've come to the end of this video. Thank you so, so much for staying to the end of this video. If you haven't subscribed, please make sure you subscribe on your way out. Turn on your notification bell. I always insist on that. Super important. Turn on your notification bell so you'll be the first to like and watch any my videos anytime I upload. And make sure you give me a thumbs up before heading out. See you next week, Sunday at 6 p.m. Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.